So without further ado, let's just get into it. So what I remember is we got into a gunfight here and then we lost. Oh, what's going on? Oh. These loading screens, okay, I gotta back off ASAP. I don't even remember what we're doing. Yeah.
Mr. V. A pleasure.
Dexter Deshawn in the flesh. Ample indeed.
Let's roll. Mind if I ask you something right off the bangle? Would you rather live in pieces, Mr. Nobody, die ripe, old, and smelling slightly of urine, or go down for all times in a blaze of glory, smelling near like posies, without seeing your 30th?
You're either somebody, or you fizzle out into nothing. Night City don't let you choose.
Oh, but it does. See, in my line of work, I choose to be Mr. Chill. But folk who try to take advantage, well, they see the beast inside. All right, listen close. Scanning a Mr. V?
What happened?
Hang on. I got a question of my own, man.
Dialogue just bugged me watching. Why me? Around.
Could've had Jackie or T-Bug sitting here. Could've just done this on comms.
Call me old-fashioned, but I like to look anyone I do this.
Look how bad his arm looks.
Had the pleasure of meeting the Jackster in the past. And sweet T-Bug helped his brother out 2 years ago. So here we are.
Reflection.
Besides all that, got a special little pre-mission just for you.
I don't know, it doesn't look... Oh, just,
Let me hear it. What's the job?
There's this prototype tech. A biochip, to be precise. Job's to grab it. Simple.
Yeah? Guessing it belongs to a corp.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka. Surely that's no problem.
Just a death sentence. NC's Arasaka's turf. Nobody fucks with them here.
What can I say, Mr. V? High risk, high reward. First rule of the afterlife. Besides that, I'm no leadhead. Ain't gonna leave no trace for them to follow, cause we're gonna do this clean and on the hush-hush. We understand each other.
You work this out? Got a plan?
Two things. First, a conundrum with the Maelstrom boys. Needs active resolving that. Second, to rendezvous. Simple. Client who brought us the job's anxious. She wants to parlay with one of the team.
What's the issue needs resolving with Maelstrom? Got a beef?
Slot in the shard. Got a classic tale for you. Psycho gang doing his thing 2 weeks back. Jumped a Militech convoy. Got away with the gear. Corp don't even know Maelstrom's involved. Now see, convoy was carrying the flathead, a little combat bot, a prototype.
Oh, what's going
I
on?
I need me that bit of high-grade military.
Is it supposed to be lagging like that, or...?
Because if we don't get that bot, we don't get no soccer chip. And we sure as hell don't get no happily ever after.
For sure, that wasn't supposed to be doing that.
It's a single-use toy. Now, I flat-out purchased the damn thing from Maelstrom. Problem is, I did so from a gent went by the name of Brick. I say when, because Brick was the leader. 3 days after we'd sealed our deal, his friend and gangmate, one Simon Randall, aka Royce, plain dropped his ass. Royce is in charge now, and I got no way of knowing if he aims to honor his predecessor's word. To add to this shitstorm, one Meredith Stout of Militech has developed an interest in said convoy.
Royce guy. What's he like?
A straight psychopath. Chrome-loving kind.
Big club in this town.
I'll give you that. Except few of its other members. No matter the stakes, would put a friend and associate through an industrial microwave dryer. Apparently, first thing to burst are the eyeballs. Get a nice clear pop. Then the rest goes goulash.
Corpo agent, what's she playing at?
Hell if I know. Been skidding around town asking after the convoy as if her life depended on finding it. The one lead she's got zip-tied in her trunk.
Sounds Sounds like she was waiting on the transport. Got stood up. Monochrome in the back's probably her chief's. Got nothing from him or on him, so she's keeping it just in case. But she needs to find the stolen gear before the boss is when she fucked up.
Well, Mr. V, that is some impressive deduction. Naturally, use that intel as you please. Preferably well. Of course, to do so, you'll need that frazzled cat's info. Sending it now.
Client, what's her thing? Why she need to meet?
Woman's name's Evelyn Parker. Vetting her wasn't easy. Put the word out I was looking for any kind of intel.
Right, and?
Some brothers from Pacifica got back to me. Told me to stop looking. End of convo. Anyway, our little client insisted on meeting someone with skin in the game. You know, who'll be there for it all. Yours truly will be remote. T-Bug ain't no people person, and Jaggy's only good at some things. I know you know what I mean. Pretty much leaves you.
I think I got everything. Time I got to work.
Well, that's just music to my ears. I'll set up the meet with Miss Parker at Lizzie's bar. Flathead, though, is gonna be all you. One more thing, Mr. B. Quiet life or blaze of glory? Later now.
Good talking to you, sir.
Dexter, talk to Dex.
Yeah, Gordito's a big deal. Literally a nod, yeah?
Guy certainly knows how to protect his biz. Wants to put us on a few small kinks. Prep work, I guess. Before lining us up a big job. There's this combat bot, military prototype. Maelstrom clept it. Then Dex paid to take it off their hands just before the gang goons had a switch up in management.
Heard about that. Royce versus Brick. Hostile takeover.
That sums it up. Dex wants us talking to Royce. Gave the deets of some Militech agent, too, but I don't know how much help she stands to be.
All the better. I'll be ready.
Nick, you don't sound thrilled. Royce, what do you know about him?
He's fucking whack something special. Junkie snort junk. Royce. Snorts chrome.
Okay.
Then there's the other thing. Gotta meet the client who put the job on the table.
Well, what's
Evelyn
Dex
Parker.
Do? Ride around in his limo, chat chicks up on the hollow?
Parker wants to meet someone on the crew. Dex gave me the nod.
He must know what he's doing. So,
Parker.
How you wanna play this? Maelstrom or Parker? What's first?
Parker, I think I ought to see her first. See what she's like, what she's after.
In that case, I'll hit the All Foods and put my nose to the ground. Sniff around. Hasta luego.
I heard that, I swear. Go to Lizzie's bar between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. What time is it now? By the time we get there. B thought just occurred to me, you can't start your career in the major leagues right by sporting some rank of a t-shirt. The wind blows a lot stronger up there on top of the world. Old timers like me hate to watch you kids cash gold. Left you a couple things in your stash in your apartment. Give him an honest try and a bet that fit just right. Well, what'd he say? doesn't even afterlife. The afterlife. Oops. Where is it? That it matters. Be a little off, but it won't be too bad. Slow times are brutal. But it would have been faster than walking, so can't really complain too much. Where we have to go. What? I'm so confused.
Luxury, Karen Tao recently expressed interest in the purchase of Pacifica property with the aim of constructing a new server and logistics center. The city government has openly considered selling the land for a single euro dollar. A gesture. The idea that Karen Tao demonstrates commitment to eradicating the district's criminal presence. Today's final story is an unwelcome one for pet owners. The canine ownership tax will increase to 1,000 euro dollars per dog per month.
Try out our freshly developed new tastes and let your tongue be amazed.
Take a pulsar to the job.
All foods.
This one's stronger.
Watson residents. A homelessness problem plaguing the district's sewer system due to the use of potent neurotoxins.
Exactly. I can't jump.
Looking a little put out there, Input. Interest you in a preem, BD?
Not my first time.
Don't remember you.
Cause I didn't get in through the front.
Huh, get a load of this one. Right. Rules are simple. Someone catches your eye, you do not grab them. You find him in the catalog, ask for a BD, and get yourself a box. No recording, no copping feels when the guards ain't looking. In you go.
Have fun, Input.
Welcome to Lizzie's.
get you something.
So, curious. The name Lizzie's, is that the owner?
Not for a long while, no. And it's none too sweet a story.
Now I'm just flat interested.
Real Lizzie ran a strip joint out of this place back in the day. Lizzie's Bar. Girls were paid right, insured, even had decent security. Good spot, all in all.
Let me guess. It didn't last?
No. Tiger Claws took care of that. Tiger beat one of Lizzie's girls, real bad ones. No hesitation, Lizzie blasted the guy's balls off. Gang came back the next day. Liz was done.
Tigers gave this place up to the Mox in the end, though, didn't they?
Sort of. The Moxes had to make a deal with them. Luckily, they kept their heads, organized quick. Big boss now is Susie Q. But the sign stayed up, out of respect. Biz booms to this day.
I'm looking for Evelyn Parker. You know if she's here?
Who's asking?
Big tipper. Generous when I get the answers I'm looking for.
Appreciate the gesture, truly. But afraid I don't get paid to talk. Opposite, actually.
It's all right, Mateo. I was waiting for this one.
Cold jacket.
Evelyn Parker. I knew it was you as soon as you walked in.
Sensan? Only tequila I drink. How would you know?
I like to know everything about the people I work with. Either that or it was just a lucky guess.
To the support me.
Why are we meeting here? Any particular reason? Actually, it doesn't seem much like your thing, this place.
I'll take that as a compliment. Come on. Know a place we can talk where ears won't prick up to listen. We'll be in the lounge, Mateo. Anyone asks, we're not here.
What can a horny girl really? Like me?
Why don't you just tell me the truth?
I just told you.
To say about you. Called you professional, effective, and trustworthy. I hope he wasn't overselling.
You don't give a rat's dick what Dex thinks. We both know that.
You have trouble accepting compliments?
No, just think flattery's beneath you. Am I wrong?
Maybe Dex is beneath you. Have you known each other long?
You writing Dex's bio? Hate to disappoint, but I just don't know much.
In other words, you hardly know each other. Yet he fingered you for this job. Curious.
Shit, buzz Dex right now if you're getting cold feet. I can wait.
I doubt he'd add anything I haven't already heard. Anything I'd really like to hear, for that matter. There's only one other bunch that's worse than fixers in that respect. Used car salesmen. I'll go with my gut for now.
Let's cut to the chase. What do you got for me?
Your target. I trust you know what it is.
Relic. Secure your soul trinket. Key tech in the program, actually. We're tangling with Arisaka, making this heist one dangerous, risky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
Arasaka's poured billions into personality transfer technology. But me, I just want the data on this one. The chip is tucked away inside Compeki Plaza, the hotel. You ever been?
Arasaka seems to have quite the touch with that hotel chain. But I gotta say, Compeki in Tokyo still leagues above the rest.
Two are identical to each other.
Japan staff, huh? The service can't be beat. Singapore, Paris, Washington, all the rest act like charity case cousins by comparison.
Well, it's hard to argue with that. True.
So where's this chip hiding exactly?
In a suite on the top floor. The room's occupied by Yorinobu Arasaka.
Yorinobu Arasaka? In Night City? Guess the scream sheets weren't lying this time.
It's on the lips of everyone in the city. Saburo Arasaka's only surviving son, heir apparent to the Arasaka Empire, in town. Please.
Could it be? Emperor's prepared to cede his throne after 150 years? Doubt it.
Only a handful of people in Night City know what the Arasaka's real plans are.
Telling me you're one of them? Look, if you've got any spare aces up your sleeve, now's the time to show them.
Now this should make your prick perk up. Yorinobu recently swiped the chip from an Arasaka laboratory. He's made a deal with Netwatch. Aims to sell it to them. Have you spotted my ace yet, or do I need to spell things out?
Fine. So no Arasaka security on the device, because Yorinobu whisked it away in secret. Now, where's he hiding it?
Likely in a specialized container. One that mimics an organic neural environment. On the outside, it looks like an ordinary briefcase.
And the case is?
You'll see for yourself soon enough. Provided we're done gossiping about the Arasakas.
Heard a bit about Yorinobu. Studied finance and biotech in Tokyo. Probably to please his father.
Mm-hmm. Saburo was grooming him to be his successor.
But then Yorinobu cut himself off from the corp. Joined the Steel Dragons, nomads from Tokyo. Heard they were planning an Arasaka coup, or its downfall.
Hmm. That flash of youthful rebellion ended like it usually does. Yorinobu returned to the fold, but the bitter taste remained. You know your stuff. But that's only one side of him. There's another. An intelligent man who has his own designs on the corp.
Could be another power-hungry corpo dick, like so many others.
Ever tried to imagine what life might be like for an emperor's son? You have everything, yet you are no one. Nothing. At least as long as you remain in Saburo Arasaka's shadow. I sympathize. It's a vulnerability I understand well.
And one you plan to exploit fully. Okay, what's next?
Now comes the best part. Follow me. Got something for you. Should help you plan. Brain dance from Compeki Plaza.
How's a brain dance supposed to help? Need facts, not thrills.
I think it'd be good for fun.
Jacking off too in those boxes. No. Hey, we weren't finished.
I hate that.
Now, it can be a very useful tool. Good for analyzing details human perception, even boosted, doesn't grasp. Exactly what you need.
So what's on the tape?
Yorinobu's suite. The glorious interior. You'll need to locate the relic yourself. Hope I grabbed enough detail to make that possible.
Understand.
Would you
didn't mean to. I'll do whatever I can to fix it.
Hold up. Mean to say you recorded this?
Mm-hmm. BD rec implant. Why, you object?
Supposed to be Yorinobu's pad on the tape. Means you were inside. You know each other?
How else could I get all this intel? I know him pretty well, actually. We have an arrangement. Strictly business. Suits us both, I think.
Let's see this brain dance.
Judy'll help. She's a Mox, too. Besides, we go back, years. V, this is important. Judy's always been there for me. Always helped out. I trust her. But she's a Mox, not the latest member of your crew. Try not to forget. So, you'll be a good boy. Yeah, tread lightly. And keep that tongue on a leash.
Relax. Believe it or not, I'm no stranger to tact. In biz or life.
V, he's here for that BD role. And V, this is Judy, best brain dance editor I know.
Enough already.
Brain dance guy.
Impressive looking setup. Need all this to process brain dances.
Mm-hmm. Analyzers, sensory sig amps, acoustic amps,
nudity everywhere.
Facial expression translators.
Judy.
All right. Your BDF.
What do you think? Will it do?
Still pretty raw, but yeah, ought to do.
Mm-hmm. V needs to get deep inside. That's most important.
So, let's calibrate. Tune it to him. Believe me, I've dealt with worse. Should see the jig-jig street porn we gotta contend with sometimes.
So, we drop V inside. Let him look, let him rummage around, right?
How about it, V? Raw brain dance. Ever taken a dip before?
What do you mean by raw? How does this differ from the ready?
Huh.
Oops.
Ready-mades, provided they're well-made, should feed you feelings and impressions you'd never have the chance to experience yourself in real space. But it's mass-market shit, so it's pre-crafted, hard-coded, fenced in and manageable. A raw one? Well, it's more like a virtue enviro. Get to move around, look at things in detail. Editors use those layers to fish for juicier emotes and impulses, then use them to pad the BDs that go to market. Sit down, settle in, and we'll get you going. Create your sensory profile first.
Okay. Hit me. Just promise me it won't hurt.
It won't. Not this time. Now sit still, look at me. Gonna run the analysis soft. Should feel a slight tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now let's set the optics and other sensory sigs. Look smack into these two screens. It's an eye exam.
Get a lot of requests like this?
All the time. But it's usually stuff the girls scroll at the club. I take that and do some routine porn tuning.
Crank up the orgasms?
More like cut out all the other shit. Fucking's business as usual for these guys. Their minds wander to grocery lists, spouses' birthdays, late bills, whatever. But even refigure things, mold the emotions into something unique, unforgettable. So, I can't complain. One more sec. Need to get the pain receptor limiters in. Okay. All set. You need to test your profile first, tossing in a sample BD. You can use it to get to know the editor. Now let me see. Where could we...
Can't he just use my recording? Why are we wasting time?
So we don't risk our necks? Besides, won't take a sec. Got something here. Should be perfect.
Boot it up.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you the tailored version first. Let you get your bearings. Then we'll jump into editing mode. Be diving in 3, 2...
Just a little loading screen, as usual.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it, got it.
And remember, everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high. Okay, on you go.
Everybody, on the ground. What I see you kissing the flooring. Money, now, or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God.
Whoa, yeah, hey,
now, before I blow your fucking head off.
It's another loading screen, of course. Would it really be Cyberpunk if there wasn't? Screen. Of course, of course.
Slow, deep breaths. Your cortisol and adrenaline spiked, but the soft activated your hormone blockers. Nothing happened. You're alive and well.
That's,
that flash of intense
shock. It's
kind
of extreme.
I can still feel it, I remember. Fuck, that last second. Could have warned me how much it hurts to die.
Trust me, real death hurts much, much more.
Not so sure about that.
You'll be fine. Got everything set up? Let's switch over to editing mode.
Let me guess, another loading screen. Of course, another loading screen. Nothing to do on it, just the black screen.
full cam control and analysis mode, so move around, zoom in and out, whatever else you come up with. Think of it as your own little sandbox. So, analysis mode, you control playback, can even pause when you feel the need. Then you use the editor console to unpause. Try it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out, and we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
Dream as hell, right? Well, that's not all. You can speed things up or rewind, whatever you like. Give it a try. Rewind. Roll it back to the top. All good. Neat. Now try fast forwarding a bit.
Plan simple. Do nothing up. Don't get creative. You go in.
Okay. You can also reset the recording. That'll take you right back to the beginning. Try it. Now for some fun. This here's why you came in the first place. In analysis mode, you get to view and even scan details of the enviro recorded by the BD roller. Focus on the heat. The gun this gonk gets from his buddy at the beginning. Now scan it.
Everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high.
Okay, right here. This tech records everything, every little detail, even the sights and sounds the roller was never aware of. To see the sources of the recorded sensory signals, switch to the audio layer in the editor. Go ahead and try that now. Okay, good. Now you should see several sound signatures in the store. Choose one and hone in on it.
Shitheads! Go restock. I'll take the register. How about you suck a bag of dicks, eh?
So, any thoughts?
Unbelievable. Seriously, like what's happening right next to me.
Yeah, it's how BD recording implants work. They pick up everything, all the elements in the background. Then an editor tweaks them, makes them pop. Keep playing with the sound, explore it a bit. We'll move on when you get bored. Sometimes you can analyze extra layers in the raw, stuff the roller's cyberware picked up.
Like what?
Ev's got Kuroshi optics that grab infrared, meaning you should be able to grab heat signatures from her recording.
Huh, hella nice.
Now let's wait till the guy punches out the gonk at the counter.
Down! Everybody! On the ground! What, I see you kissing the flooring! Money!
Scanning works on peeps, too. Walk up to the wounded chick. Try scanning her. All right, next thing. Scroll forward to the part where our artist gets a lead injection.
Now, or I will fucking drop you! I swear to God! Look, you're now!
See that? They shot him and he never saw it coming. But you will. Here it comes. My favorite part of the game. See the blinking thing over the entrance? Surveillance cam. Must have caught our shooter. You'll see in a sec. Cam feeds to the screen behind the clerk. Roll back to where the screen's in the kid's field of vision, then scan it. Chumba shot him. Probably planned to all along. Must have got a nice slice of cred on the black market for a BD like this. BD freaks are ready to pay a preem for a real flatline. Anyway, if you've seen enough, you can exit.
Okay, that was kind of cool.
Right?
It's too bad most of the BDs we do here are only good for flogging the log.
Anyway, you ready to do this? Look at your wreck?
Dunno, I... Let's take a break. Still feel like that kid when... Oh, yeah. Think I'm done.
V, there's no time. Get it together, please.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Just need T-Bug to link in.
Whoa, who?
Runner from my crew, security specialist. She'll tell me what to look for while we analyze. No problem, I hope.
Actually, it is a problem. Not what we agreed, Ev.
Evelyn, I won't get a damn thing out of this without T-Bug.
Judy, please.
Ev, he wants to bring a runner in? What part of that don't you understand? Do I know she'll only perch in this footage, observe, not fuck with anything?
Me. I'm your guarantee.
Yeah, right.
Help me. This one last time. I promise everything will work out, just like we planned.
Okay. Call T-Bug and we'll dive in.
Hey, V, what's happening?
Bug, listen. I got some useful footage from Compeki Plaza. It's a brain dance.
Compeki? Oh, thought as much.
Someone there with you?
Judy and Evelyn, they're chill. They helped me work through this BD.
Uh-huh. All right. You gonna tell me what this is about?
Listen, need your help. Got no clue what to look for once I'm in.
All right, see if I can walk you through it. Jacking into your tech now. You've got to give me access. Opening port 1779. Secure protocol? Good, I'm going in. Should be getting my request now.
Got it. You ready?
A millisecond. Okay, connection confirmed. Now some quick tip ice and we're clear. Ready to dance.
Fire up, Judy.
Same thing.
Felt her fear. Sure got it under control quick, too.
I said,
that is kind of scary.
They'll have my head for this. Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But,
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to...
Listen in on that conversation, V. Could be something important.
Finish.
Forget Ida.
Oh. I said, they'll have my head for this. Then, you shall.
servers. Gotta be. Fancy doodads in here need to be controlled. Father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change and he'll live forever in his tiny froze dwarf. I need a minute to finish.
The program is just a trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father. He's taken a particular interest in this project. He can certainly explain the risks.
My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change, and he'll live forever in his tiny, frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
We'll listen to this. Saburo is an adult despot, utterly removed from reality. Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years.
Documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. You must provide them.
Heard that? Relic docks gotta be around here somewhere. Look for them.
Relic docks, okay. In the visual layers, scan your Nobu's data pad while it's turned on.
Sorry to make you wait. Business can be stupid.
It wasn't long. Is everything all right? Just got any candy left? Pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right.
Somewhere in this.
Oh, got any candy left? Step was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right back.
Wait, what?
Step was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, no dip.
Yeah, that's how I love you. Focus on me. Oh, got any candy left? Step was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, nightstand.
I've got an idea. Hey, you down the leg?
It's done.
I've got an idea. Be right back.
It's like I'm really...
V, eye on the prize, focus.
In the visual lair. Why does it switch me to audio mode? What? The screen turned off. So like, how do I...
Manual details a special tip-controlled container. Relic needs to be kept real cool.
So, chip's gotta stay in the freezer.
Yep, could damage it otherwise. Okay, switch on thermal layer detection in the editor. Should be easier to spot where you are know who's keeping the chip.
Okay, so we just gotta look for somewhere hot. Those are lights, so they're gonna be warm.
Donaghy's. Looks like Mr. Arasaka had something to celebrate. Really think you'll find the chip in there? No way. Temp's too low. Could fluctuate. Nice try, though.
The fridge.
Just a fancy-ass fridge. Tip doesn't match the guidelines. Won't find a thing here.
What's this?
Right. Grab the heat sig. Matches the spec in the docks.
Yorinobu's got the case here. Guaranteed.
Mm-hmm. We got it. Good work. Looks like we got everything we need. Quit out of the editor.
Scan the apartment security system. Do we find the security system?
Thank you.
Let me generate keys. I can forge their six.
I said no.
They'll have my head for this.
Then you shall perish for a good cause.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough. Forever in his tiny frozen.
I should not even be listening to such things.
You will listen to this. Saburoi is an adult despot. Utterly we have not seen eye to eye with Hasmati. I am quite sure. We will now wait for sorry to make you wait.
Not even long for you, Ward. Is everything all right? You seem tense, edgy.
A moment. It will pass.
Remember what I need.
Last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea.
Yeah, whatever. Screw it. Some nice silence that was just broken by my voice. I hope you enjoyed that right before I get back
get
into gameplay.
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache and your data. You were never here.
Put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for handling BDs. I already uploaded your calibration settings.
Cool.
Not as sophisticated as what we got here, but should do the trick.
And it keeps you out of harm's way. Clever.
Speaking of harm's way, know what I see looking at you? Walking, talking corpses.
We needed that recording, Judy. The BD practically does our job for us.
The BD will be the death of us. Seriously.
If Arasaka finds out you have it, you're dead. I'm dead.
Judy, relax. Nobody will ever know.
Yeah, Judy,
Evelyn,
relax.
Please.
We got this.
No shortcuts. You go that route, City'll always win. So be careful.
Of course I will be. Besides, we'll talk in a bit.
Thanks, Judy. Really. And don't worry.
V.
I know what I'm doing.
Let's walk.
Okay.
Well, what do you think?
I think I see how you know so much about Yorinobu.
It's simple. Men like pillow talk a bit too much.
So it's just about the sex?
Biz. And biz only.
Biz only, okay.
So, what now?
Makes sense.
V, do this job for me. I mean me alone. No splitting the payout with anyone else. No middlemen. No Dex.
You want to fuck over our fixer? I knew something was up.
Dex is a middleman, and a useless one at this point.
Evelyn, you don't mess with fixers. That's the one rule every merc in this city knows. And actually follows.
But if we're smart...
Doesn't matter. A mistake like that will cost you a rep. And without a rep, you're nobody. You sure you want to do this?
Better ask yourself that question. Do you want to spend the rest of your days blasting scabs? Or become a legend overnight? Your choice.
If I agree, there'll be hell to pay, for sure.
I know. Whatever you decide, stays between us. I can offer 50%. Eddie's enough to do whatever the hell you like.
I'll be finished. Dex won't forgive a dirt move like this.
Dex isn't the only fixer in town. But my offer's the only one you'll ever get.
Let me think about it.
Mm-hmm. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
To level up again, we haven't assigned any cup points.
How things looking, Mr. V?
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Compeki was worth our time.
Beautiful. T-Bug already called. Said she's working her map. And the flathead?
Nothing yet. On it now.
T-Bug says no chance of that ship without that bot. To work then, Mr. V.
To work then.
Gina and me sitting at the bar. And she's rattling on about the bank stuff, yada, yada, yada. All the while, I'm angling to get a word in, because I need...
No one minds that I'm opening the washroom. While they're in it, I'd be freaking out. Call Militech Agent Meredith down.
Telling me how you got this number.
No more than your number. Heard you misplaced a convoy.
You. Spill what you know. Don't make
there
me
a problem.
Transport fuck up's toxic for you. I know. So listen carefully.
I didn't mean to do that.
Then you're gonna meet. See if we can't find a way to help each other out.
Mutual self-interest. Agreed.
What if we were playing last?
first exit off Skyline, driving towards the NID. Storm channel under the overpass. Meet you there.
Okay, how far are we? 500 meters. What's going on here? What the?
You guys never get bored, do ya?
What's going on? Let's meet with the Militech agent and see if we can figure out this predicament we're in.
Meredith Stout. Take it you were the one to call?
Decide the caller. What's going on here? Whoa, okay.
Thought you could blackmail me, fucker? Set conditions?
Oh, damn.
Got any more for me?
Calm the fuck down, I just want to talk! Christ, Meredith!
Shut your trap! That fucking thing ready?
All set.
Now answer my questions. Honestly, forthrightly. Are you here alone?
I'll tell you who's alone. You. Failed to recover that transport and you're done. With not a soul willing to help.
Not another word. Do a sweep now.
Yeah, sweep me. See what happens.
Now listen to this. This piece of shit, Anthony Gilchrist. Is he your contact? Is he the one who leaked intel on the convoy?
Got no ties to Militech. None.
Checks out.
So how the fuck do you know so much?
Come on. All corps use the same playbook. I know the game inside out. Listen, I know where the transport is. I can help you. Just
want a favor in return.
I told you! I fucking told you! I'm not the mole! Jesus Christ!
Shut him up!
Unhand me now before I...
Oh man, that guy's so dead.
Him you can let go. Wanna hear what he has to say?
I need a bot. Flathead model. Guys who ripped you off have it. Promise me that bot. I'll point the finger.
You have a plan how to deal with them?
Could just take it by force, but they're expecting payment. So I could go that route too.
Fine, the latter. But on one condition. You pay with our money.
That's the kind of subtlety they teach at Militech. Ship spiked with a virus, clearly.
That is true.
Something goes wrong, I'm the one they'll fill full of holes, not you. Time you were straight with me. What's on there?
A tracing algorithm latches on to financial streams. Nothing you need to worry your head about.
Sounds solid enough. I'm in.
Encrypted shards. Some shards you find that the world would contain information hidden behind data encryption measures. To decrypt the shard, first either open it through the notification when you acquire it, or find it later in the shards tab under journal in the main menu. Then select crack security to unlock its secrets.
You pay with that chip, and that's all you gotta worry about.
There's two different ones you can... So confused, you can only pick one, maybe.
Try to fuck me. In any way.
Eddie's on the crate ship for Queen.
You're making a mistake! The cops are any good as dead! And she'll take you down with her!
Alright, let's go meet up with Jackie. See what is next for us in the Cyberpunk universe.
There you are.
Oh, let me hear what you fired away.
T-Bug show any sign of life? You two talk?
She's up to date, fired up to work with Dex. Parent already. They're familiar, you know? Worked together before Dex took his break.
Been waiting long?
Mi madre always said patience pays off, so...
So Dex already paid the maelstromers for the corpo bot. Thing is, can't be sure the gang goons are still willing to hand it over.
He paid up front? Híjole. Well, whatever. Let's go get this tech. You scheme yet? You got a plan?
Tech and me, we found some common ground. They're footing the bill for the bot.
There's a lot of scratch to toss away.
Forget it, Jack. It'd be like we never had it in the first place. Anyway, who knows how this deal's gonna shake out.
So, into the Borg Beast Den?
Let's go see these bastards.
All right, let's knock on their door.
Onward.
See if they even open up.
Good to the gate of all boots.
I hate these Borg fuckers. Just had to be them.
Just a gang like any other, right?
I'll take the Valentine.
Talk to Royce. Dex sent us.
Main room. We've been waiting.
Cozy place. Could use a few plants, though.
Test, test. This out. Hopefully there's no
guys. They look damn well prepared.
Don't think I've ever seen security like this in a chow factory.
Gear from the Jack convoy. Gotta be. Must have been all over it like maggots and dead meat.
Personnel mine. Directional shrapnel spitter. My favorite.
Subtle.
So what kind of loot do we got here? What's this?
Stay cool. They're just trying to spook us.
Here to see Royce. We got biz to transact.
Mr. Royce is busy just now. You'll deal with me.
You got a bot. Model MT0D12. Called the Flathead.
And? The hell you care?
Guy I represent already paid brick for. I'm just here for the pickup. I can talk direct to Royce if necessary.
Nah, you talk.
I can't get rid of this fan noise. Dum-dum.
Now
planet. Annoying. Alright, let me know if you do like it. seven eyes.
Piss so fucking hard? Fucking ass on the fucking couch!
Make me.
Thought you'd never ask. Sit your ass down for a planet bullet in your skull.
Jesus, Jack, what gives?
Primerito, I don't like this guy's tone. Segundo, sitting on your ass makes you an easy target.
Sit your ass down for a
Jack,
bullet.
Sit down.
This ain't gonna end well, but... Shit.
Well, all right. Come on. Got lighten up. Take a hit.
What is it?
Skeef. Shit kicks you in the ass.
It's a fucking rush, man. Gotta feel it for yourself. Come on, give it a whirl.
Thanks, I'm good.
Whatever you say, straight-edged princess. Here we go. A flathead. Model MT0D12.
See now the tracks.
Militech's not gonna come looking for it?
Fuck them. They can hop around and try. We removed the serial number and lifted access locks using our soft. What's yours, it's yours.
Need to see it.
Suit yourself. Fucking tricked out this thing. Dynamic thermal optic camo armor. Full cognitive immersion with a radar.
That is pretty badass.
Pinned down prototype actuators made of titanium vanadium Kevlar composite. And watch this! Fully integrated link too, so when the spider starts crawling up walls dangling from ceilings.
Mm-hmm. Could lose your lunch.
So what you think?
Have to do.
Look at that. Picky little fucker. Let's see your cred.
Brick got it. It's all paid up.
Brick got it. I don't see any fucking brick around here, do you?
Asked you. Fuck brick then. Let's cut a new deal.
Now that's good business sense. Alright, you want the flathead? I better see some eddies. Asked you a question.
Seeing as you already got the eddies for it, you ought to offer us a discount. Big one.
A discount? You know, you never did say who sent you. Never did say who you're working for.
Dexter Deshawn. That's who.
Dexter Deshawn. The lard ass who punching animal fucked half of Pacifica? He ain't dead.
Nope. He's alive, well, and kicking. He sends his regards.
So you can consider my offer now?
I don't wait!
Here's the cred. Hell, I'll even toss in some info as friendly bones. Militech's on to you. They're close.
Wait, what?
Cred ship was spiked with a virus. Don't worry. I wiped it.
Check it.
Doesn't
just happened.
You just take the damn bot and get the fuck out of my factory.
Okay.
If this is a trick, I'm gonna introduce you to our meat grinder.
Got what we came for.
Nova, so now leave. And hey, after you get Dex's dick out of your mouth, tell him I say hello.
Piece of shit.
Shit. Let's get the fuck out of here. Follow me.
Militech couldn't manage it on the fly with the chips. They rolled in the big guns. More their fucking style, I'd say.
Argue with that logic.
get out of here.
Yeah, let's get out of here. I'm tired. I'm a little hungry.
Here you go.
Hey, what'd he give us?
I can't fucking believe that guy.
What'd he give us? Seems useful.
Your fire.
He's coming for me.
I'd like a word with him.
What the heck
shot
is
at my
on?
People.
You know this guy?
Anthony Gilchrist. Still alive. And not hogtied for a change.
Have a good memory for names. But that's nowhere near enough when Militech personnel get shot up.
They drew and fired first.
A fact of no consequence to Militech management. But if you'd worked with Stout, I'd be dead by now. Might not have intended it, but you saved my life. Now I'm saving yours. Makes us even.
Gotta admit, didn't expect to see you here.
You were followed, but I'm sure you know that. Stout's people were on your tail, my people were on theirs. In the end, she lost her nerve. Thought she hopped in bed with Maelstrom behind her back. Hit the big red button prematurely.
Classic. When you don't know what to do, why not order an all-out assault on a food factory?
Mm-hmm. About sums it up. I made sure it blew up in her face. Business with Maelstrom. Hardly ever ends well.
What happened to Stout?
She placed some bad bets. Her clock ran out. Simple as that. Suffice to say, you won't be seeing her again.
And you? Why are you here?
Well, I still don't know who the mole is. I was hoping the Maelstromers would shed some light on it. By the way, where's Royce? Need a word with him, too. It's been a pleasure.
Shit, V. I wasn't sure we'd walk out in one piece.
Think we're done. What now?
I had enough for one day, let me tell you. Let Dex know we got his toy for him. Fatso ought to crack open a bottle for us after what we did for him today. Ahí luego, V.
How's things looking, Mr. V?
Got the bot.
And how'd it go? Run into any trouble? And what about the Militech angle?
Sure, of course it was trouble. Royce couldn't have given two shits that you and Brick had shaken on.
How'd you get him on board? You used the corporal woman?
Met with Stout, managed to strike a deal.
Well, well.
Gave me the chip with the scratch from Maelstrom. I warned Royce. We made a deal.
You got some balls, Mr. B.
We're all set. Ready to go. What now?
Now we do the job I hired you to do. Grabbing that biochip. We'll talk about the rest at the afterlife. See you there.
Great. Be there in no time.
See you, Mr. V.
Enter the afterlife. 1.3 kilometers away, so we gotta fast travel there. For sure.